everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel if you're brand new, but if you're a regular, welcome back. So today's video, I'm going to be taking a look at my MacBook Pro. Well, you are, because we're going to do a what's on my MacBook Pro 2018. Now, I did a Mac Pro one, I did a MacBook Air one back in 2016. So that was a fair while ago now. And something that I think I definitely need to refresh. I think during that time, my MacBook has gotten better with the apps I'm using, but I've also minimized a few apps that I wasn't using. So I will put the video previously in the description below so you can maybe see the differences. But I think this one will be a super interesting one if you're a MacBook lover or you're even considering moving to Mac. So guys, just before we dive in, I wanted to thank our sponsor for this video as well as this whole week of videos here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel, and that is SetApp. Now you may have heard of SetApp before. I'll explain what the service is in a minute, but you may have heard of it because they are also the sponsor for Series 2 on the Tools They Use podcast. That is my brand new podcast all about apps and resources that other people are using. So that would be a really interesting one if you'd like this channel. So SetApp are basically the first ever subscription service for Mac applications. There are hundreds of apps inside of one suite, which is awesome, but you only pay a monthly rate. Now, it's being raved about at the moment, mainly because people are, when they set up their MacBook Pros or MacBooks, and they're like, I don't want to spend the earth on new applications and new resources. Well, basically this has a ton of awesome apps available in one suite and you only pay a set rate. So I'll include the link in the description below, guys, but I've also done a review as well. So you can check out SetApp in its entirety in an unlisted video below. So you can go and enjoy all of that good stuff. But anyway, guys, the sponsor for this video is SetApp. So thanks very much to those guys. But let's dive in and let's jump on the MacBook Pro. Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Now, as you're seeing on my screen, you are seeing my MacBook Pro. So this is going to be a full overview of what is on there. And what I want to do to start off with is explain my sort of mini story, I guess, with my devices side of stuff. So maybe from the last video that I did on MacBook, or what I have on my Mac, I was on a MacBook Air. Now, I've only been using this since maybe January time. I've been using a MacBook Pro, and it's been really developing over time, mainly because previously I never had the need to upgrade. Now I do. So you will be seeing quite a few of the more intense applications for the video editing here. My day-to-day role sort of is more demanding on that side of stuff. So I've just been looking to grow that out. But today's video will just be an overview of the apps I use. And I'll also explain a few of the functions in terms of going over things. Okay, so I think what's best is to start with the bottom bar down here. And I think that's a good base because I keep most of the important apps down here. Now you're probably seeing I am viewing Bear, which is a few of the notes I've made on my iPhone. So that's a reason that's popping up. Obviously I've got Finder here, that's sort of fixed. Camtasia 3. So Camtasia 3 is my video editing software, and I use that on a daily basis. Now, this is something that I probably need to have a separate conversation with you guys about. Things 3 is, at the moment, my temporary to-do list application, and I will explain why in another feature, but it is installed and ready on my Mac, and so is Todoist, but that is probably something I need to explain in a week's time. Newton is my default email application, and I find a lot of value in it. Just a note, I work with the Newton team, so that might be a little bit of bias, but I fell in love with this application long beforehand. Notion is my application of choice for planning. I use it and have it pinned down here. Chrome is my default browser. Spotify is my go-to music playlist, I think, or music player. Slack is my main team application for communication with some of the clients. iTunes comes up whenever I stick my phone in. I really try and get rid of it most of the time. And as you can see, it'll drop out. And Evernote, I actually don't have it as much these days up here. And that's no reason. It's just because I've gotten used to using the
search spotlight bar and typing in Evernote. And I really want to do that more often with some of the lesser known applications, like the ones that I don't want to use all the time, like Spotify or even Slack, like keeping them in Spotlight or not on the dock at the bottom, mainly because I don't want to mess things up. So I want to explain up here as well. So obviously I'm recording, so it's got a little record light. Evernote, the quick note one, I use quite on a lot, because all you have to do here is start typing your note. You can even click off it and come back to it. And then as soon as you want to save it, it goes save to Evernote, and it will go straight into the note inside of Evernote. Now I have timing installed as well, so I will explain that a little bit in a bit. But it basically tracks your productivity across your day, giving you an outline of how much time you spent on certain applications. Up here, I've got Unclutterer. Something I want to do a full review on separately, but it's actually a neat way to, at a glance, quickly get access to the copy and paste stuff. Forklift, which is quite helpful across the day. Cloud App, which I continually rave about. I didn't have it in my last Mac Book Air review thing, but it actually has been a massive savior. So all you have to do is clip a screenshot or a screen recording. You can even create a GIF or annotate. But honestly, I use this so often, like to just visually demonstrate stuff to people, it just saves so much time. Over here, I've got SetApp. Obviously, the SetApp subscription works pretty simply. There's obviously a review in the description, so you can go out and fully understand what it does, but you can find it in the Finder. That was a hard thing to say. You can find it in the Finder. You just have to go to SetApp and see all of the apps that you've got connected here. So these are the apps I've got connected at the moment. Obviously, there's tons more, but I like to keep things pretty simple as I go. But you can search for applications up here, which is pretty cool. So if I'm like, okay, I actually want to get Ulysses up, then I can click that. And if I don't have the application, so let's say I have Vocabulary. If I open that one up, what happens is it automatically takes you to a page with it on. And obviously you can install it or uninstall it, which is pretty easy. You can go to My Dashboard and see all of the items there. But there's a full review in the description if you want to go over it. They've been lovely enough to sponsor this feature as well, which is great. The only other things I have at the top are, now I have, I don't know why I've called my AirPods Carrot Face. I think it's because some of my other devices are called Carrot Face. I don't know why. It helps me distinguish it when I'm in coffee shops and people's Wi-Fi pops up. Not that my name isn't already distinguishable. So I connect up my AirPods, which I've recently got. I probably need to do a separate feature on this, those ones, because they're so good. Obviously got AirPlay, my Wi-Fi, and all of the regular stuff along the sides. Now, one of the things I don't do in my day is, is click the Do Not Disturb. I always have that one on during the day. First thing I turn on in the morning, and I do take it off in the evenings, but I tend not to have it on, mainly because they're distracting coming up across here. Now, I'm not sure what that is. If you can see it, it's like a screenshot-y thing. I don't know. So I'm going to go to the sort of like view of all of the applications. So I'm going to scroll to the first page. Obviously, I've got all of the default applications installed. They come with the Mac. And I want to explain a few that have come with Chrome. So obviously Chrome comes with a few web applications that are now installed on your Mac too. They're almost like shortcuts. You've got Clean Google Calendar as a separate application. This is probably something I do need to catch up using, but it's essentially like a nice view in Google Calendar. You've got Chrome Remotes Desktop, Pocket, and these all take you to separate pages. Now I have got Todoist still on here. Again, probably needs a full video on this, a massive 2 or 3 videos, because people are going to freak out. Newton, obviously accessible here. Bear, which I use for scripting, mainly because I like to know what's coming up in my videos, and I tend to use it like this. So I just have like the two panels out on here, and I just use it to list some of my features, but I love Bear so much. It's gotten some, it's a huge part of my routine. Obviously got Slack there, and as I go across, here are a lot of the other bulk of the applications. Evernote, my note taker, Notion, my planner, Spotify, and I've gone through all of these. I've got all of the default Microsoft applications in case I need them. Zoom US is my go-to video conferencing tool. I have fallen in love with it, especially for one-to-one communication, recording the podcasts. I've never Skype next to it, and that's probably because a lot of people still use Skype and need it, so it's a regular feature. And of course, I need to have access to it. Snagit is a screen capturing one. I downloaded it, not sure about it, so I've kept it on here. ScreenFlow, again, is very similar to Camtasia 3. It helps you to record features, but I'm going to be using it for certain client projects. Monday, I installed that one with the thing. Station, now this is an interesting one I haven't actually checked out. This was a recommendation over lunch with Alex, Icon, and he was like, Francesco, I can't believe you don't know about Station. And I was like, Station? I've heard of it. I mean, I've seen the logo, I've seen lots of apps logos, but I hadn't actually gotten time to go into it. Basically, it's a communication application that combines all of your communication into one spot and just saves you a huge amount of time. So you'll probably see a feature on that separately. Now, the setup there, obviously, good task I using to review at the moment. Forklift. Forklift, I'm finding very, very helpful. It's an application that allows me to view my Finder, but also be able to move stuff across different items. So if I was like, okay, I need to move these over to there, you know, it does help me to organize items as well as keep things clean and progress as well. So that's one of my nice ones. Ulysses, I'm yet to check out. I've got it installed for a review. StopAd is one that helps me to block adverts. I'm still getting used to it. Things, again, temporary to-do list application. GifFox, an application, as well as GIF Brewery 3 that I use to manage GIF management, especially when I'm posting them on social media. Audacity, I'm getting used to, although I need to spend a lot more time with it. Audio editing software. TickTick, I have installed for reviews. Unclutterer, again, saying copy and paste. Timing. Now, Timing is available on the likes of Setup, but basically I use it to view what I actually spend my time on. So you can see here, web browsing. I spent 11 minutes web browsing today already. That's bad. I got Notion as well. Notion open for 18 minutes. And that was mainly due to the review I did this morning. And Newton was open for 15 minutes. Google Things was open. You know, all of these applications you can get insights into. And you can even go back to the previous day, although this was a Sunday, so I can imagine it was a lot less, and give you an outline of exactly where you spent your time on and your most active hours, as well as being able to review all of the amazing information and even add your own. So it's basically a time, not time manager, a time tracker. That's the one. I've got Flume here, which is my Instagram viewing feed. This is available on Setup as well. But so all I have to do is log into my Setup, log into my Instagram, and once I open this up, I get all of my Instagram feed and I can see everything at a glance, which is so. The final two are Noisio. I'm gonna go with Noisio. Essentially allows you to play different tones for different times, and of course you can unlock these different areas. They've got tons of sounds and you can mix them up with each other. It's been one of the most loved applications that I've found in the last couple of weeks, and Airtable, which I use for a review. So that is my entire MacBook Pro setup. I don't really have any other applications that I find hideously useful in this. I obviously use a ton of apps on the go, and I use a web browser quite a lot. So hopefully this feature found some use to you guys. So guys, just before we go, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments what you think, what apps you're using on your MacBook. But a big thank you to Setup for sponsoring this week of videos. Make sure to check them out and the podcast as well, where they're sponsoring me or the podcast in general as well. Thank you very much, guys. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.